Excellent. That was excellent. But is there anything else you want to add? What else do you do for besides carve chainsaws? I believe you said you're also into acting in some capacity.
Well, I've always been a character, but now I'm getting paid for it. And this last January, I decided I wanted to make some money in the TV movie business. Started out doing some shoots. Looked on Craigslist, found a shoot that was happening up in Poughkeepsie. And that basically opened my door this year to getting into that film business down in New York City. And a funny story on this is I swore I'd never take my clothes off for the film industry.
Uh-oh.
And on this first shoot, they liked my natural style, and the director called up the next day after the shoot in Poughkeepsie. Says, look, we need you down in Brooklyn right now. You got to come down right now for this shoot. And so I said, all right, you got to pay me a little bit more for this. And I drove to Brooklyn, got lost 5 times trying to figure the streets out there. I mean, you know, how many times are you going to drive on the same street that goes nowhere? But I finally ended up at the location of the shoot, and I walk in. They hand me the script about some guy in the bathroom. And sure enough, I walk in, and they said, all right, right here, drop your pants. Now, it wasn't anything as X-rated as you might think, but they were filming a shot on this guy that was very phobic about cleanliness. And I happened to be a guy sitting in the stall, so they got a shot on my feet and inside this stall. Problem with that shoot is I'm sitting there 45 minutes and my legs went numb. And I was really worried about falling out of that stall with 10 people in that room observing my fall. So needless to say, you can make your plans and you can try and follow through with the things that you truly care about, but you want to get into the film business, you're going to have to do a few things that you weren't quite prepared to do.
Now, I noted that you brought a clip of a past performance that you've done in some type of, was it a movie, or could you tell us a little bit about this clip that we're about to see?
For a few years, you know, you try to get into these movie shoots up in the Hudson Valley, and I would go down to these shoots, and they were looking always for extras or background people. And we went to this one shoot up in Rosendale, and there weren't very many people there. And they had this actor who I'd seen her in a few movies, Kira Sedgwick. And they needed somebody to flirt with her in this cafe scene. And I happened to be the only guy. And so I actually had an opportunity to work out dialogue with Kira, and had a good time with her. She's totally professional. And we ran through our dialogue, did about 3-4 takes on that, and then they produced the movie. And fortunately, I am in the movie, but they edited most of our dialogue out, and I have 2 words in there that I say.
Let's take a look.
Where do you think I could look for a job?
What sort of work do you care to do?
Any kind.
I have a cousin down in New Jersey. He lives in Verona, New Jersey. He's about to have.
I'll be with you in a minute.
Hang on.
Just remember, I'll be working at the hospital until 8.
And so I should have picked you up at like 10:30, right? So that's a sob, right? Out there, your car, that's a sob, right?
Oh, yeah.
Does it have heated seats? Maybe a reversible hood, right? Because I've worked on it.
Hey, listen, is there someone I can talk to about a job?
Delia was a good waitress. She worked fast, remembered everything, and frightened the customers just enough to keep them in line while inciting their lust if they were men.
Surprise. All right.
And wariness if they were women. Anyone was rude to her, she spat in their food. It seemed fair. She never did it when she had a cold.
9 times 30?
Great job, Bruce. Great job. Any thoughts about that?
I've lost weight since then.
This is The Path, that show that covers positive people, places, and things in the Hudson Valley. Once again, I'm Damon Finch. Ladies and gentlemen, Semblance of a Soul. Valley's number one show that covers positive people, places, and things. I'm over here with Semblance of a Soul. Guys, that was a great job. How you doing?
Thank you, Mr. Finch. We're doing well.
You're doing well, huh?
How you doing? Thank you for letting us play.
All right, what are your names?
I'm Michael Wunderlich, lead singer, lead guitar, songwriter for Semblance of a Soul.
I'm Metal Mike Margiana, bass player, background vocals, things like that.
And I'm Justin Wunderlich, drummer.
He's the quiet one.
He's the,
Okay, can you guys just tell me a little bit about your band, where you guys from, and what's your inspiration?
Well, originally